Are you ready to venture into the dark shroud of Enkanomiya? All right. Follow me. Here's hoping I have the chance. Next year, I'm going to apply for Swordfish 1 to be redeployed into Spectre Management. Because if it's that, or spend more time in Enkanomiya, I'll take my chance with the Spectres. Those armor monsters, closing in on you. It's the stuff nightmares are made of.
Totally understand.
Anyway, we should be safe for now. There shouldn't be any more danger from here on out.
Hey, what's up?
It's Yabe, the odd guy from Stingray 3.
You seem kinda chipper compared to all the other soldiers.
Do I? Well, I've pretty much always loved horror stories and ghost stories and stuff, ever since I was a kid. This trip to Enkanomiya is something else, though. Totally mind-blowing. Super fun. 10 out of 10. Would come again.
Totally do not understand.
Well, I mean, it's pretty sweet to have the chance to come to Enkanomiya. I actually kind of wanted to look into the Bunkoku puzzle while I'm here. It's the first of the four great puzzles of Enkanomiya.
Yeah, please don't do that. We're the ones that'll have to come rescue you.
Alright, well, never mind that. There's a makeshift camp at the top of those steps over there. Yeah, you should head up and catch some rest if you haven't been there yet.
Different from all the others. Are you human?
Well, she is, obviously. Just not a native of Watatsumi Island, that's all.
And you? A human hatchling? Oh, really? Because I thought that humans lose the ability to fly when they reach adulthood. Just like the Bathysmal Bishops lose the ability to see in color when they reach maturity.
Sumi, you seem to know a lot about bishops.
Wait. How do you know my name?
Oh, the wounded soldiers mentioned you.
Oh.
Greetings. My name is Ueno, acting captain of Swordfish One. We're here to evacuate the wounded and support the traveler's investigation. Swordfish One needs to rest and reorganize before commencing the evacuation. I'll see you later.
So you're here to help resolve this, hmm? Very well. It's taking all the energy I have to keep this light shining. I don't have the strength to try and combat the spreading darkness, too.
Do you understand what's going on?
The Void Realm is invading. The people of Byakuya-koku believe that there are three realms. The Bishop Realm, the Human Realm, and the Void Realm. The darkness spreading in Enkanomiya comes from the Void Abyss. Neither bishops nor humans can endure it.
But don't Bathysmal bishops like the Turk?
No. They hate the light. But only because down here in the depths, the presence of light signifies human activity. In fact, the Bishop Realm is the realm of pure, primordial, elemental beings. It's actually referred to as the Light Realm in most books. The seven sovereigns of the Light Realm are the seven foremost elemental dragons at the pinnacle of the raw and primitive elemental forces.
So that's why Tsuyuko called this the Three Realms Gateway Offering.
Three Realms Gateway Offering. Not far off the mark, actually. But technically, I think it should be called the Triangle Gateway Offering. Because the source of the darkness from the Void is the three towers at the corners of Enkonomiya's triangular borders.
Oh, the three towers! The ones where we did those trials!
You've been there before?
That's a long story.
Oh.
By the way, Tsumi, what's up with the weird mask?
To hide my face. It has to do with some things that happened as I was growing up. I just don't want to scare anyone, that's all. Does that make me untrustworthy in your eyes?
No, not at all! You've been helping the wounded all this time. Everyone must be super grateful to you. It's just that...
Can't say I really understand what you're talking about. Anyway, if you want to rid this darkness from Enkanomiya, you can come to me for guidance. Of course, if you can trust me. I'm going inside to tend to the wounded and check in with the new arrivals. Please excuse me.
What are we gonna do? Paimon really wants to trust Tsumi, but... Oh, how about we go ask the wounded?
Greetings. Because of her strange mask? Well, you've come to the right person.
Cool!
I was one of the first people that she rescued. Straight away, I thought there was something very weird going on. Who is this shrine maiden who knows the lost ceremonies of Enkanomiya? And why is she covering her face with a mask? So I started pestering her about it. I wasn't going to let up until I got an answer.
And?
There weren't so many people around at the time, so eventually she let me look behind the mask. It was actually pretty normal for the most part. There's just one thing she's trying to hide. Her eyes have snake-like pupils, thin vertical lines.
Whoa. Weren't you scared?
I probably would have been if every Watatsumi Islander wasn't so familiar with our legends. Or I should say, our history. The first familiars of the Watatsumi Omikami were the vassals of Watatsumi. Legend has it that they are a half-human, half-snake kind who helped our ancestors fight back the Bathysmal Bishops. They were said to have disappeared long ago. But then Tsumi showed up, and as soon as I saw her snake eyes, I instinctively trusted her. It's like the vassals have returned to help us in our moment of need. I'm no expert by any means, but I think Tsumi can be trusted.
Hello, what can I help you with?
Hi there! We wanted to ask you what you know about the masked shrine maiden, Tsumi.
I see. What are you looking to know exactly? I've tried asking if she's seeing anyone, you know, or whether she's looking right now, but she seems pretty tight-lipped about her love life.
That's not what we meant at all. We were more wondering, do you think there's anything suspicious about her?
Suspicious, huh? Suspicion, the unknowable, the unpredictable, unexplored territory, mysterious, enigmatic, enchanting, bewitching, compelling, addicting, yeah, know what I'm saying? I am being serious. Okay, look, if I had to pick one thing about her that's suspicious, I'd say, okay, two things. Number one, her mask. It's pretty scary. I don't know why she chose it. Number two, some kind of pendant fell out of her sleeve when she was bandaging me up. It looked like it was a broken off piece of something. So maybe when you put them together, it makes a whole. Huh. Maybe the other half is held by Tsumi's lifelong sweetheart.
Sounds like you hit the nail on the head, so, you know, maybe ease off a little, bro? It looks like they're resting. Let's not disturb them. I don't think we've got enough answers now. Let's find somewhere to recap what we know so far. Tsumi's just inside the room. It'd be a bit awkward if she hears us talking about her behind her back.
So, how's it going? Have you made a decision?
Still thinking things over.
Nothing wrong with that. Even if you're just too afraid to venture out, no one can blame you.
Of Orabaxi's vassals. Based on her actions, it seems like all she wants to do is protect the people of Watatsumi Island. And from what she said, she's doing everything she can to combat the darkness Enkanomiya. So she seems pretty trustworthy. Then let's go talk to her about working together.
So, how's it going? Have you made a decision?
Yep! Let's team up to tackle the darkness!
Okay, then take this. It's called the Bokuso Box. I found it in the Dainichi Mikoshi when I was looking for a solution. Actually, the Dainichi Mikoshi was where I found the method and tools for the Sento ceremony. Lucky I can read human writing.
Why wouldn't you be able to? Or did you mean it's lucky that you can read the ancient Enkanomiyan script?
Nothing. I just meant the script in the Deep Sea Healing Arts Compendium. I don't actually know if it's ancient or modern. Never mind all that. Let's get back to business. The Bokuso box collects light. It can dispel the darkness from the void within a small radius. So, for example, with the power of the Bokuso box, you can turn monsters affected by the darkness back into their original forms. As it happens, there are some monsters causing trouble around the camp. Go and try out the Bokuso box on them. I will join you shortly.
Down!
Right here. Emerge.
I can fix this!
We're way behind schedule. We're way behind schedule.
Come on! Focus!
Illusion shattered!
Right here. Emerge. Right here.
You're a good fighter.
You bet! We were the ones who went and got the Blood Branch Coral that one time, after all.
You! So you...
What's wrong?
Nothing. If what you say is true, then I'm sure you'll be able to conquer the three border towers quite easily. Also, there are a few things I need to explain to you. According to what I have read, the fundamental purpose of the Watatsumi Goryo Matsuri is to use the Serpent God's life force to awaken its second familiars, the Senga Coralia. They are creatures that break down raw, primitive elemental energy into the milder elemental energy of the human realm. The giant coral is a symbol that the Sangha Coralia have been awakened by the serpent's blood. The mass awakening of the Sangha Coralia causes a transformation in the ecological environment of Enkanomiya.
Makes sense. Even if you took away the darkness and the monsters, Enkanomiya would still look pretty different now with all the new plants and ore around.
Things are even more complicated than usual this time. The darkness from the Void Realm seems to be suppressing things in the Light Realm and the Human Realm, causing them to come to a standstill. You may need to use the power of the Bokuso box to dispel the darkness and allow the ecological transformation to continue. Please, try to solve the problem using the Bokuso box. I'll wait for an update for you under the statue over there.
Ready for anything. Next on the agenda. Right now, emerge. Right now, right here, right now.
Go as one!
Well, what do we have here?
It seems that you have mastered the Bokuso box. Now, let me tell you about the ultimate purpose of this operation. As I said, we need to proceed to the three towers on Enkanomiya's borders. They're towers of the Void, restored to their original form by a certain Abyss Adherent.
Abyss Adherent? Wait, do you mean...
He's a purveyor of incessant nonsense. Somehow he found out about the three realms and the three corners and brought those things in using abyssal technology. Then he started disseminating abyssal energy using the towers. This caused great suffering for both the Sangha Coralia and the Bathysmal Bishops. I don't know why he's doing this. For us, The abyss is highly toxic for them. Intoxicating is more the word. Addictive, but still destructive. Maybe he just likes to toy with people and stab them in the back.
Paimon knows exactly who you're talking about.
You know him? Then it seems we have a common enemy.
Oh, you bet we do!
To get rid of the darkness, you need to climb to the very top of the Towers of the Void and activate the Light Realm Chisel, which will let in the energy of the Light Realm. In Enkanomiya, the ley lines of the human realm, the elemental currents of the Light Realm, and the dark currents of the Void Realm are all exceptionally strong. Also, I only performed the Sento ceremony going off the steps in the book, but I believe the key to the ceremony is the statue in front of us. You can offer crystals of Light Realm energy to it to increase the Bokuso box's power. Also, resting here can restore the box's energy. Please, take this hand-drawn map. I've marked out the locations of the three towers for you. You'll need to explore one step at a time, and I'd recommend you start with this tower. That's as much help as I can offer you. I'll be waiting here for the good news.
Thank you. On the agenda? Behind schedule. Next on the agenda.
Right now, right here.
Next on the agenda.
Go as well!
Access denied. Right now. Right here. Right now. Hear me. If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life. Right here. Right now. If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life.
We're waiting. next on the agenda? We're way behind schedule. Next on the agenda. If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life. Maybe it'll spring back to life.
Let me try my blade.
Right here, right now. Emerge.
Hey, this.
Go.
next on the agenda? Should we really be off work this early? There is still a lot left to do. Behind schedule. Agenda?
Oh, what a cute treasure coffin! Huh?
Show them. Right now, emerge. All hail. Access denied. A sight to behold. Right here, right now.
Go and fly!
Go!
Huh? Barbados, guide us.
If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life.
Yeah.
climbable.
Emerge, right here.
Yeah! I can fix this!
Go and play!
Right now. Emerge. Huh?
Here. Right now.
I swear by my sword!
Ta! Emerge!
See?
Denied. Right here. Emerge.
On the agenda?
right here. Emerge, right now.
Born of ice and frost.
Emerge. I'm always watching. Right now. Emerge.
Barbados, guide us.
Next on the agenda.
Go! Go!
Access denied. We're way behind schedule. Next on the agenda. We're way behind schedule.
We're way behind schedule. Way behind schedule. Way behind schedule.
on the agenda. That's everything.
Right now, emerge! We're way behind. Next up. Right now, emerge! Right here. Wind, hear me. For Rex Lapis. No touching. Emerge, right here, right now.
Come on. what a cute treasure coffin!
On the agenda.
Leave it to me.
Ha! What a cute treasure coffin!
Right now. Born of ice and frost. Next on the agenda. We're way behind schedule. Next on the agenda.
Open it up. Show me what's inside. Right here. No touching. Yeah.
If we bury it, maybe it...
We're way behind schedule. It's so nice to de-stress. Next on the agenda... Emerge, right here.
Oh, what a cute treasure coffin. chest is like unwrapping a gift.
Is it time for me to join you? Treasure coffin.
Thank you.
behind schedule. Behind schedule. If we bury it... on the agenda. Access denied. Right here. Emerge.
Yeah.
treasure coffin! Oh.
If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life! Go!
Emerge! Right here! Emerge!
Go as well!
Guide us.
If we bury it, maybe it'll spring back to life.
We're way behind schedule.
Dreadful ending.
down. Like this. You win this battle.
Wind, hear me. Maybe it'll spring back to life. Phew.
If you lie on the grass, you can feel the heartbeat of the world. It's so nice to de-stress.
Tell me that's every.
Next on the agenda. Next on the agenda. We're way behind schedule.
Maybe it'll spring back to life!
What do we have here? Traveling to other worlds is all that anyone seems to be writing about these days. Goodness knows what they find so disappointing about their own world. Most humans could have the entirety of their fleeting lives chronicled in but a few short lines. Their stories really make for terribly dull reading.
Thank you.
clues nearby.
Whoa!
Traveling to other worlds is all that anyone seems to be writing about these days. Goodness knows what they find so disappointing about their own world. Most humans could have the entirety of their fleeting lives chronicled in but a few short lines. Their stories really make for terribly dull reading. Personally, I think the idea of things staying the same forever is quite beautiful. But alas, that is simply not the way the world works.
Boot.